Okay, so I found the problem. The problem was just this button was a little dirty. Once I put some contact spray on there, it worked perfectly fine. So, you know, this can happen. But yeah, that's probably something that I have to tell about the design. The design uses analog inputs because the Arduino Pro Micro doesn't have enough pin inputs. Now, you could have been saying, hey, use like a shift register. And yes, that is possible that you can make this work with a shift register. The problem with a shift register, though, is that they require a clock signal. A clock signal of by exactly 10 milliseconds. So 5 milliseconds on, 5 milliseconds off. And that's a delay on your input. So I have chosen for a route that specifically focuses on the performance of gaming instead of something that would be more stable. So yes, it is definitely possible something dirty, something half resistor-ish is fucking up your motherboard that could actually have an effect on your inputs. So it is definitely something that you have to keep clean. I could have probably gone for a Teensy board or something, but then the price would have gone up by a lot. So I think this is honestly a good compromise. Just know that obviously this design isn't perfect. But yes, now that the soldering and the testing has been done, I hope you've been able to follow the soldering part. I know it was a bit of a slideshow, but yes, if you're following and once you've done this, what we're going to do now is put the keycaps on there. If you order these 12x12x7.3mm buttons, they're linked in the description below, you should normally get these keycaps with them. And once you've soldered your buttons on the PCB, it's just a matter of fact of putting them on. And voila! Now that you've done that, your analog joysticks should come with these little caps. It might be that the links that I've posted in the Google Drive below might once get outdated. I'll check on them once I've uploaded this, but after that, sometimes AliExpress listings change. So make sure that you check whatever is linked below in the drive and it corresponds with what I've typed in the parts document, okay? Anyway. You grab your little joystick caps and you just put them on. And look at that. Now you've got a fully functional controller. The steps that I'm going to do after this are actually completely optional, or you can do something else. I've really let this up to interpretation of all of you guys, because I'll be quite frank, my 3D designing isn't really good. It's more practical than, you know, artsy and has all the details in that. No, it works. That's all my 3D designs are. But you don't even have to 3D print for this controller. You can just decide to use like something wood, make some, craft something yourself. The dimensions of this PCB with the buttons and one without the buttons, just a layout and where all the holes are actually also in the Google Drive. You can cut something yourself, you can make something yourself, and have fun with it. Also, the 3D parts that I'm going to use now are also linked, obviously, in the drive below, also with an inventor file format, so that you can check it home yourself, maybe even change a few stuff. I don't know if it works with Fusion 360. That's something you might need to find out yourself. I'm sorry that I don't use Fusion 360. I got an inventor license thanks to college. But yeah, if you can, you can just check the 3D designs yourself. You can make, maybe do some improvements, maybe do something else that you like more. Anyway, if you don't mind my designs, you can just straight up print them like is. But yeah, as you could have seen previous time, I tried one of these. It actually broke. I actually had a few redesigns of this that I actually didn't film. A lot of them broke, but this one actually works. If you're going my route, what these are actually little brackets you put over your joystick, because you can play like this perfectly fine, but the outer parts actually have a very big dead zone, which makes it so that if you go in there, your controller doesn't really know what to do. It just pushes it all the way there, and this is just no input at all. This bracket is going to limit that movement, which feels more natural in your hand and actually makes you better at playing the game, because you know you're not in a dead zone constantly, you're actually in a functional zone. But yeah, it's very easy. This is why these two little slots are actually in the PCB. You just grab one of these and you just slide it over there. And voila! That's how easy it is. They don't drop, they feel perfectly fine, and as you can see, they limit the movement. And obviously, you just print two of those. You can put them either way. I know there's a little slot over there, because if you look at the other side, it would have collided with this solder joint. So, but I've done them on both sides, so that, you know, you don't have to look out after that. It's just a little bit of quality of use thing that I've done there. But yeah, you just click it over there. And voila, you've already installed them. It is that easy. Okay, and for a backplate, I've actually 3D printed something, but the screws haven't arrived yet, so I haven't been able to test it out. Unfortunately, AliExpress is taking its sweet long time, and all the stores are closed thanks to Corona right now, so I have to wait for a moment. But thanks to editing, y'all don't have to. So, with the magic of editing... So, it's been already a while I waited for those screws, and they still haven't arrived yet. But luckily, while looking through my spare screws, I have found four identical ones that I can use. Fucking sucks that I had to wait so long and it still hasn't arrived, but you know what, that's AliExpress for you. Sometimes shit doesn't arrive fast enough. Anyway, what I want to show y'all first is the backplates that I'm not going to use, which are these three. As you can see, it went from fat to slimmer to slim to a total redesign. I just want to show this that, you know, every design has a progress. If you're planning to take this on yourself, don't be afraid to make a few mistakes, you know, shit happens. Anyway, this is the backplate that we're going to install. If you do want to make your own design and you want to share it, leave a comment below, you know. Anyway, let's install this, shall we? And hey, look at that! Fits pretty well, I would say. Pretty comfortable. You know, the PCB is exposed, so, you know, it's a little bit more perceptive against dirt and all that shit. But, you know, it works. It's not gonna shock you, it's only 5 volts. The worst that can happen is that something short-circuits and the button keeps getting stuck, then just, you know, clean it. Anyway, now that this is done and the controller is fully completed, I'm going to explain to y'all how I've programmed this. The programming and all that shit is also available in the Google Drive below, but I'm going to give you a short explanation on how I've done it and what you might need to change if some values are different. Anyway, let's get into that, shall we?
Alright, so here we are in the code. So, first things first, the first thing you want to do is get a board package. As you can see, if you correctly installed the board package, you see X-Import AVR boards, and then you just select the Arduino Leonardo with X-Input. You can also choose the Micro with X-Input, but they're pretty much the same, honestly, there's no difference. I just click the Leonardo. Anyway, then you select your port, like normally. Currently I have not plugged it in, so it won't work, but you know, normally this is where you select the board you want to use. Then in your code, what you want to include is the X-Input library. Again, all this library in the board packages are also in the Google Drive in the link below. So, first things first, here is where we initialize all of our buttons. This is where the pins they are and what they're connected to. This is for L1 and L2. Hold up, I totally did not make a mistake here and shared that in the previous version. That is my bad. Anyway, good thing that I reached it, I guess. Anyway. So as you can see, here's where I initialize analog 6 to be this name, and here's where I initialize a blank value as well, which is going to be the value of L1 and L2, which is going to be used for later. The same is being done for pretty much all the analog pins. Here is the joystick. These are as well buttons, but I gave them a little separate sections, and these are also initialized where I specifically put them on 0. Why did I do it here, and why did I not do it with these ones? I don't know. But honestly, if you say 0 here, right, well, it doesn't really matter. So in the void setup, what you do here basically is where all your pin modes, they're all inputs. All the buttons, all the for the joystick, they're all inputs. Here's the setup for the X input, where you basically say, okay, this is the value range that your joysticks have. So with Arduino, it's between 0 and 1023. And here you say your X input has to begin. In the void loop, what we do here is we basically set all of our analog reads on the values we set and we put them on the values. Can't technically do an analog read within the command where we need these directly, but again, this is the way that I've done it. This is a bit more better for me. Am I chaotic? Yes, do I care? No. Anyway, this is where doing analog read on the pins itself because I haven't defined it before. Again, a bit chaotic. I'll admit my programming isn't that streamlined, but it makes sense for me and that's a weird thing to explain. But here we do an analog read on the pins themselves. This is the y-axis and this is the x-axis. And then you basically said, okay, set the joystick, the x-axis and the y-axis are the different values it can have. And this is for the joystick left. You do the same thing with the joystick right. These are just ifs and else for the buttons, so you know if and else, if the button is high, then you know the buttons get pressed. If not, the button gets released. These are the same, but just for R3 and L3. And here's what I really want to talk to you about. These are all the different values I said about buttons. As you can see, D-pad left and D-pad up, the press of this, has this value. D-pad left and press D-pad left and release has this value, and so on and so on. And these are the values you want to maybe do an analog read on. If you, let's say, you press left and up, but a different value comes than that's in here, then I would say this is where you have to change them. Put an analog read on this sensor pin where the D-pad left and up is for value left and up, and then you can just read it. Do like a serial print so you can know, hey, what analog value is being displayed here, and then you can, deciding from that, put a value in here if it does end up being different. I've done a broad range, I would say, of 10 bits. Here is even with 20. But honestly, this is something you're going to have to look after yourself. See what values it is between, and then you put just the values, the lowest value here and the highest value here. Do the same for all the buttons. And that's all the analog buttons, basically. And that's not all there is to the programming. It's really not that hard. This library is made super easy. I can't really recommend it enough. If you want to make a controller for like PC gaming and you want to make use of Xbox inputs, this is the way to go. The only thing that I would say is a bit tough about this is with the board packages you have to install, because not only makes it basically your Arduino into an Xbox controller for all of its rest of its time, but putting another program in is kind of hard. I've explained it in the beginning. You have to press the reset button twice. It's not that easy. Anyway, like I said, this code is on the drive. You can check it out yourself. If there are any more questions, leave them down in the comments below. But let's get back to the video, shall we?
So guys, I don't have much time left on this video, unfortunately, so I'm going to have to keep it short and simple. First, the 3D design is changed, but I'm going to put the updated version in the Google Drive below, so don't worry about that. Second, I have tested this controller for a full week. There were no glitches that I could have noticed. So for me this is, well, just know that it isn't perfect. I am just a hobbyist. I am not a professional. Third, all the files of this project will be posted below. The Gerber files, all the stuff that used as a parseless as well, the 3D files, the STL files, all that stuff. It is down in the description below. This thing you can do whatever you want with it. I do want to say, if you do plan making this exact same controller, I am not responsible for if anything goes wrong. I'm sorry, I am just a hobbyist, I am not a professional, I'm not selling this product. The only thing I'm doing here is sharing my files. If you do find a mistake, please let me know so I can fix it as fast as possible. I do know of one little mistake, and that is there's a little T-junction trace over here, but that is that big of a problem because we're not even close in the gigahertz race. It's not gonna get affected, but I'll keep it in mind for next time. Now that that's out of the way, something I also want to say is, honestly, thank you guys so much. The support on these videos have been amazing. One of these parts even got like over 1k of views, and the last video got over like 25 likes, I think it is now. Actually, scratch that, it is over 30 likes as of currently of filming this. So holy shit guys, I can't thank you enough. All of you have been amazing. I hope I've made a good enough video for y'all to follow this and have a good enough explanation that you feel comfortable doing this yourself. I know this isn't like a good guide. I'm sorry, I'm really not that great at all that explanation of this, but I hope it was good enough for you to feel confident to get on this yourself. Believe me, there's not a whole lot that can go wrong. As for the future, I might update this controller again, but honestly, now that I'm having a lot less time on my hands, I can't promise anything, so I won't do a, like a light goal or anything like in the previous one that I did. For now, this is going to be its final incarnation. If there is ever going to be an update, you guys will be the first one to know it. But that's it. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like, subscribe, and all of that good stuff. And I'll see you in the next one. By the way, expect more electronic projects. Not soon, because like I said, I don't have a lot of time, but expect them. Anyway, goodbye everyone. Love y'all.